Roxy Music. Welcome to my ranking of all the Roxy Music albums. There are only eight studio albums to consider, and you know, not part of the ranking, but great live album as well. It's not part of the ranking, but I have to mention first. I have to mention Viva Roxy Music here. This would, you know, this all. Almost made my top 10 best live albums. I did a video a few months ago about my top 10 favorite live albums, and it didn't make it, but it was close. It was, you know, some place like 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. You know, it's up there with my favorite live albums. Great versions. I think it was released 76 probably, because it features tours from, you know, from the best time as a live band, in my opinion, like 73, 74, 75, so great live album by Roxy Music. But the eight studio albums, but first of all, Roxy Music, what's my opinion on Roxy Music? I'm a big fan of Roxy Music, otherwise I wouldn't make that video. I guess I, you know, in general, I like that era. One could say the 70s, you know, but especially like Roxy Music came out of the glam rock scene from, you know, 71, 72, 73. Artists like David Bowie, T-Rex, Slade, which is probably on the other end. You know, Roxy Music is on one end and Slade on the other end. But I love all those groups for different reasons. You know, it was a very exciting time, you know, in a way a bit like a proto-punk movement with, you know, better clothes, probably. I think Roxy Music was next to David Bowie, probably artistically and also stylistically, the most interesting of all those acts, and also one of the most influential, surely next to David Bowie, the most influential of those glam rock bands that I've just mentioned, because they inspired several, you know, like I said, the punk movement, also New Wave, and what later would become New Romantics, you know, bands like ABC, Duran Duran, Soft Cell, Spandau Ballet, all those kind of 80s groups, and even the Britpop bands of the 90s, you know, I don't think there would have been Pulp as we know it without the influence of Roxy Music. So it's a band that's probably more important than some realize. There are other bands that you know, always talked about for being such influential bands, but Roxy Music gets, not always, not by everyone, but sometimes I think they get overlooked or maybe slightly underrated. You know, one thing about them, not just to influence all those groups, but you know, they even sounded like some of those groups. You know, they were maybe too modern for their own good. You know, if those albums would have come out in 1995, you know, there's the sound, there's not much difference to what Pulp did on Different Class or Blur did on Parklife or such albums. They really had a sound that was not just hinting into the 80s or 90s, it was like a futuristic sound, you know, at the time, you could say. But yet at the same time, a nostalgic sound. So, now my top 8 albums here. And number 8, I have to say, I'm not really a fan of that album. It's Manifesto from 1979. This was, you know, Roxy Music had two eras, had three eras, because they reformed as a live group like 20 years ago, but I'm talking about, you know, when they really were in their heyday. They had two main eras, and the first one lasted from 1971 to 1975. Then Brian Ferry wanted to go solo, but after like 3 or 4 years they came back with that album. And you know, it's not a very good album, in my opinion. It was quite successful. You know, the people probably thoughts now that the new wave was happening and then things like that. You know, the time was probably right for a comeback for Roxy Music, so it was timed good. But the album itself isn't that good. Dancer is my favorite track, which is a very good track, but the rest I'm not too much fond of. Number 7 is Stranded. I have it on vinyl because some of the album covers, you know, with the ladies, the album covers with all the ladies on the front cover, I often confuse them because they look so, you know, to me, kind of similar. And when I wanted to buy one of my favorite Roxy Music albums on Discogs, I came across this cover and I thought, oh, there it is, and I immediately purchased it. And then when I listened to it, oh, that's the wrong album. That's not one of my favorites. So that's the reason why I have this on vinyl as well. I have it on, like you can see, on CD too. I have all the CDs on this excellent box set, Roxy Music, the complete studio recordings. If you're new to Roxy Music, I recommend this to you because there you get all the albums plus a bonus disc where you get all the non-album tracks, so the B-sides and different mixes of singles and things like that. So that's a great way to get all from this great band. My number 6 album is their last album and maybe the most commercially successful, at least their biggest worldwide biggest hit is on there. It's Avalon, with the big hit More Than This. Great song, and the title track is also was a hit and was deserved. It's a great song again. It is, you know, this is where I think the albums are becoming really good. You know, the albums I've mentioned before, you know, I'm not the biggest fan of, but with Avalon, you know, I think from now on each Roxy Music album is really a good album. You know, this the second era of Roxy Music that started in the late 70s was more pop oriented, more conventional pop oriented, you know, like some of Brian Ferry's solo work is as well. So it's maybe not as eccentric, you know, if you're more for the left field kind of Roxy Music, that's not your album. This is more like what David Bowie did with Let's Dance around the same time, you know, to reach more a bigger audience. And you know, they did reach a bigger audience with this, but after that they broke up, but they broke up with a very good pop album, I would say. Number 5 is their second album, For Your Pleasure, from, I have to look, 1973. This is the last album with the legendary founding member Brian Eno. You know, Brian Ferry, Brian Eno, after that album they didn't want to work with each other anymore. They were probably a very, very, very different kind of characters, and didn't get along after or during the making of this album. You know, Brian Eno, as we know him from his solo career and his productions that he did, was responsible on the first two Roxy Music albums for the more adventurous sounds and soundscapes and strange early synthesizer elements. And Brian Ferry wanted to, you know, like I said about Avalon, maybe wanted to do more conventional, maybe a bit more mainstream oriented music, but you know, great mainstream oriented music, don't get me wrong. This is a great, great album. It has the big One of their big hits, the big hit Do the Strand, great, great glam rock album by Roxy Music. For Your Pleasure, number 4 is one of, you know, For Your Pleasure is a big classic, but this is also one of their biggest classics, probably. Country Life from 1974, their fourth album. This has some of their best songs, you know, The Thrill of It All I Want Is You, those are great songs. Yeah, great, great songs on that album. And this is This is kind of a peak of the first lineup. No, not the first lineup, because Brian Eno had left already, and they had so many changes, especially the bass guitar. But from the, you know, from the era before 1979, this is probably the biggest classic of the, you know, if you want to go classic early Roxy Music sound, then Country Life is a great album. Number three is, in my opinion, this is the first 10 out of 10 album, I would say. This is the debut album from, I think it's 1972. You know, all the songs, not all the songs, most of the songs are classics. You know, it starts with Remake, Remodel, Ladytron is on the, it's Sea Breezes. I prefer the cover version that Paul McCartney's brother Mike did of Sea Breezes. You should check this out, this is even better, but great songs, and this was like, you know, the introduction to the world and to their strange world, their strange sound. You know, Brian Eno was at his most flamboyant with his, not just with his look, but also with his musical ideas. So this is a great album and ahead of its time, very much so. My number two is maybe the most controversial pick on that list. You know, I guess many people would have this much lower, but I really love this album, Flesh and Blood. So in a way I would say this is the most underrated album. Again, I like all songs on there. This is very pop. This is, you know, even more than Manifesto, the comeback album was. This is from 1980, and this is when Brian Ferry really wanted to be a mainstream pop superstar. And I'm not sure if he achieved it commercially with this album. I think this wasn't the most successful album, but it's a perfect 80s pop album. And again, they're ahead of its time, because this is 1980, but this could have been also made in 1983, 84, 85 and still be considered a very off-the-time 80s album. So in a way, he invented 80s pop and new romantic, especially with this album. The first three songs, Midnight Hour, Oh Yeah, Same Old Scene, these are all perfect pop songs. There's a great cover of 8 Miles High. You know, this album also has a kind of psychedelic vibe in a way, which is strange to have a very, like I said, clean 80s production, but on the other hand, this very weird psychedelic things, and the Birds cover of 8 Miles High, I prefer to the Birds version. It's, you know, only Roxy Music could have made this album. And my number one album, only Roxy Music could have made this album as well, Siren, from 1975. With Jerry Hall on the, I think this is Jerry Hall on the cover, which at the time was Brian Ferry's wife. Then she left him for Mick Jagger. But this is really a masterpiece. You know, the first side, especially "Love Is the Drug." It starts with "Love Is the Drug." "End of the Line," "Sentimental Fool," all great songs. "Both Ends Burning," my top three Roxy Music songs. "Just Another High" is a great album closer. You know, this is like a blueprint for what Pulp would do in the 90s, I would say. And this is one of the, you know, the 70s, in my opinion, probably the best decade in pop history. But this is one of the best albums of the 70s. So, that was my ranking of Roxy Music. Thank you for watching.